have Senator Stavisky here with us now.
You have Senator Parker with you now.
Parker is with us.
In spirit.
In spirit. Okay. If you look at your voting sheet and agenda, Senator Golden's bill that is marked refer to finance is not, doesn't have to be, doesn't have to go to finance.
Okay.
I'll just scratch that out. Okay, Franklin.
Okay, the first bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1486 by Senator Marcellino, Act to amend the education law. This bill would require that the regents include a statement setting forth the total expenditures by each school district on special education in its annual report to the governor and legislature. This bill has passed the Senate twice, including last year, and if reported, would go to the floor.
Yes.
Thank you, Senator.
Senator Kruger.
I have a memo saying the School Board Association is opposed, but I don't have any details about why. Does anyone else know?
I couldn't imagine, because under present law, the State Ed Department has to issue a report, annual report. And all they're asking of the department, regents, is to just include this information on special education, which is very critical. It's a very major expenditure within each school district for a very important constituency. So I couldn't even guess, Senator.
And what, we've passed this before, but there's
yes.
No assembly same as? So there must be somebody who disagrees with this. So.
And that is not going to be you, is it?
No, I've actually voted for
yes.
it in the
past.
Okay. I thought it was a reasonable set of questions.
No, no, it is. I'm sorry if
why.
I...
No, it's okay. Yeah. Thank you.
And this would include BOCES, presumably, too. Because they do, you know, a lot of their
yeah,
operations
they do.
In special ed.
That is actually something we should bring to the sponsor's attention or have him look into. Because usually, when we talk school districts, there's usually another, right after it, BOCES. So I think
they do obviously a lot of their expenses, especially.
Right. And we should also make note that he should look for an assembly sponsor. Any other questions, comments? Do I have a motion? Senator Griffo? Any negative votes? Phyllis Rookwood.
Second bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1564 by Senator LaValle. This bill would require that any resolution that alters or amends the rules or regulations of the regents include specific information with respect to cost. This bill has passed the Senate three times, including 2013, and if reported, would go to the floor.
Okay. Any comments?
I'll remain a no vote because of my concern that this would put so many limits on the regents that they would actually not be able to change their rules or take action.
Good comment.
And for this very same reason, I am an AWR.
I move the bill.
Senator Griffo moves the bill. Any negative votes? We
no,
have
just
one
another
negative vote and one without recommendation. Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 1886 by Senator Bonasek, an act to amend the education law. This bill would eliminate the requirement that a recipient of the World Trade Center Memorial Scholarship apply for on-campus housing as a condition of receiving the non-tuition cost of attendance. It would also provide that the non-tuition cost of attendance not decrease because the student did not apply for or receive on-campus housing, unless the student lives in off-campus housing owned by a direct relative, or the student resides with his or her parents within a reasonable commuting distance of the campus. This bill has passed the Senate for three consecutive years, and if reported, would go to the floor.
Any comments? Any negative votes? Do I have a motion? Okay, by Senator Valesky. Do we have any negative votes?
No negative votes.
Okay. Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 3810C by Senator Marcellino, an act to amend the education law. This bill would provide for the licensure of geologists and expand the State Board for Engineering and Land Surveying to include at least two professional geologists. The bill defines a professional geology and sets out requirements for licensure. The bill protects the scope of practice for engineers and land surveyors and permits engineers to perform those activities that would fall within the scope of practice for geology. The bill also allows licensed geologists to form professional service and design professional service corporations, limited liability companies and partnerships, joint enterprises and partnerships with licensed engineers, land surveyors, architects, and landscape architects. This bill passed the Senate in 2013. If reported, would go to finance. We have a memo of opposition from the New York State Society of Professional Engineers, and a memo of support from the New York State Council of Professional Geologists.
Any comments?
I'm sorry, did you say the engineers wrote an opposing memo?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, okay. So I had been told they were okay. So I was misinformed. I'm still yes on this bill.
Senator Valesky.
Just curious to know, in that memo, the engineers have suggested some amendment language. I'm just curious whether you know whether the sponsor of the bill has considered the amendments or not.
I'm going to make a comment on that. I'm going to speak to Senator Marcellino. This bill has been around for quite a period of time.
In geology terms, not as ages.
And I would say to you, so let's pick let's say 10 years. This bill, in each of those 10 years, has been amended 3 to 5 times. In each of the years, 3 to 5 times. This bill is already a C version, and so whoever has an interest in this bill, I think the sponsor will obviously has considered over the long term all the amendments that have, but this, I've never, in my career, I've never seen a bill amended more times over its course. As I had indicated, and as all of you are acutely aware, we are in this era of fracking, and it is critically important that we have people who are credentialed. And the reason we have licensure and we talk about scopes of practice is to protect the public. So this bill, it's got to get done. It's got to get done. So whoever has an interest in it, come to the table, or, you know, as chairman, I'm going to use my whatever I have to move this bill through both houses, because it's an important bill. Any other comments?
I want to go on record as agreeing with the chair. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator.
And the Business Council is supportive of this bill, interestingly. Okay.
I would think.
Yeah.
I would think. Move it. Senator Valesky moves
the
bill.
Employee. Hey, if any time you get the Public Employees Federation and the Business Council to support the same bill.
That's awesome.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Okay.
We have two without recommendations, okay. Senator Gallivan and Senator Ritchie.
Okay. Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 6144 by Senator Golden, an act to amend Chapter 548 of the laws of 2004. This bill would extend until July 1st, 2016, provisions requiring the issuance of regulations by the CUNY trustees to permit New York City police officers enrolled in programs leading to a baccalaureate degree or higher to take one course without tuition on a space available basis. This bill was originally acted in 2004, extended 4 times since then, and reported to go to the floor.
Okay.
Is that because this bill sunsetted? Is this legislation because it's sunsetted?
This legislation is scheduled to expire in June.
Because we passed it in 2012.
It's chapter
70.
Yes.
With the schedule to expire in June of this year. Yeah.
So. This last passed and chaptered in 2012.
And this extends it.
For two more years.
It says in the bill itself that the previous bill would be repealed on July 1st, 2014. So we're ahead of the game. It says take effect immediately, but shouldn't it say on the, doesn't matter, on the expiration of the other day?
I'm not sure it matters.
Okay. What happens?
But the fact that, but it will, it will, you know, given our process, it'll take the full term.
Which bill?
Yeah. Okay. Any negative votes, Bethany?
No negative.
Okay. Bill is reported.
Senate Print 6377 by Senator Marcelino. This bill will reduce the number of regions from 17 to 13, with one representing each judicial district. It will require that regents members be elected at a general election beginning in 2015. The bill would also reduce the term length for each regents member from 5 to 4 years, and vacancies will be filled by a special election at the call of the governor. This is a new bill, and it's reported the votes before.
Yes,
Senator
Kruger? I have a series
of
questions. So, would it be on the ballot names for all of the 13 regions, or just specifically to your quote-unquote region?
Just in your.
So, and if the 15 people all sign up to say, I want to be a regent, all 15 go on the ballot, and you walk in and decide which of the 15 you want to vote for. If 42 people sign up, are there 42 names on the ballot? How does that work?
It's my understanding that there are no limitations as to how many people can be placed on the ballot. I can get further information if need be regarding.
Because I don't see anything in the bill that would explain it. So there's no primary, there's no, you know, again, if 120 people want to sign up to be the region from a specific region, all 120 names go on that ballot. There's nothing that defines or vets or pre-evaluates. It's just anybody who says, put me on there to be a region. Is that right? Because that's how I'm reading the bill. And is there going to be, assuming we actually get a public financing system in place, are these people going to be eligible for public financing or be within the existing campaign finance law?
Senator, I think you're getting a bit ahead of yourself on that.
No, let's say existing campaign finance law. Do these people have to file with campaign finance? They are running for office and they will be on the ballot.
By the same token, it is probably a stretch for a large number of people. How many did you say that could potentially be in 100?
You know, I represent the region that would include Manhattan. Everybody wants to run for something in my district. I don't know about your district. So there could easily be 140 people who say, boy, this sounds like a lot of fun. Let's sign me up.
Pay is so good.
Well, that's one change that the sponsor could entertain, putting a process in place.
But we would agree there's none of that laid out here.
That is.
There's nothing laid out about whether they would be
campaign
eligible. There's nothing that says that testing companies couldn't put a huge amount of money into making sure that the regents who are going to sign up for their tests are the ones who end up being the winners of the regents contest. Right? There's nothing in here that would prevent that.
That is correct. And that is a good point that you made.
I try to make the good points. I would have to say this bill is so not ready for prime time, and I would urge that we not move it through the committee today.
I concur. And I'll tell you why. If you look at the bill, it really doesn't specify anything. It just takes out the whole big chunk of language that deals with the current selection. But it doesn't offer the alternative. This is something that absolutely requires additional work. There's an argument to be made, I think, for having bring the regions closer to the people who vote, because there's been widespread, as we know, you saw it last week, dissatisfaction with the regions. Hopefully they got the message, and perhaps they will realize that there are serious questions out there about their selection, as well there should be. But on the other hand, in my recommendation to the committee members, I raised some of these issues, and I will be voting no.
Senator Griffin?
I actually applaud the sponsor for at least, as you, Mr. Chairman, thinking outside the box and trying to deal with the issue of the selection process, because I think, contrary to what we're saying here today, I don't know that hopefully they got the message. In order for them to get the message, we need to ensure that the message is delivered, and that would be a change in the selection process. We continue to hold true to the structure of the regents, but there should be a different way to do this. So I like any idea that's being put. I have a similar idea to Senator Marcellino. I think it's, from my perspective, similar to the way we elect boards of education members right now and charge them with the responsibility of educational policy, at least throughout all of upstate. So I think it's a good topic for our continued discussion, and I have no problem with a myriad of bills being proposed right now, so it ensures that we focus on the issue and then ultimately we arrive at a consensus to really do something different, and that will be the real message sent and delivered.
Senator Krueger, Senator Skibiski, you raised some good points.
I mean, for example, New York City once tried proportional representation in electing school board members. Problem was that nobody came out to vote, and really nobody came out to run either. But there are a lot of ideas here that, you know, we could certainly take a look at.
I think the election within a district
is an interesting
concept here. And I think that if there are enough votes and the bill is reported, that it's obvious that the sponsor has to think through some of these things in terms of, because you can't have a large number realistically, and I don't know what a large number is. More than five people on a ballot? Do you allow for primaries?
Yeah,
these are all good questions. As I said on the floor the other day when I voted against your region's bill, I think that education and higher education should have joint hearings and explore models that could, in fact, be better, because I'm not saying I'm a defender of the current process. It was created in 1812. I suspect a lot of things have changed since 1812. And certainly education policy is far more complex a set of issues, so I'm very much in agreement, Senator Griffo, that we ought to be taking serious looks at this. But bills that, frankly, would be impossible to operationalize. I might suggest, I know that we don't usually refer to, other than finance or codes, I would refer this to elections, because this bill actually walks down the road of all kinds of election law, far more than education law. And one might want to explore statewide elections for regents, but I think you really need to think through all the complicated ramifications of doing so.
Senator Griffo, is your bill statewide?
No, it's by district and everything, too. It's just concept. But there's many good points here, but I think it's just an important discussion for all of us to have.
I think, we'll see. Are there any other...
There is. Senator Serrano voted no, and Senator Parker was without recommendation.
Without recommendation.
Okay. Senator Valesky without recommendation. Senator Stavisky and Senator Krueger are no. Phyllis reported.
Yep. We have something else? I don't want to jump up if you're going to raise a new issue.
Go ahead.
No, I was just wondering, were you closing the committee? Or do we have more time?
We don't have any more bills, but no, we could.
Oh, no, I didn't want to be rude by running out. That would be great of them. Just check it.